Hello, in this video I will give a short introduction about the certification process of the KBV and I will give you a short introduction of the document Prüfpaket elektronisches Rezept. So when you are implementing the e-prescription for Germany, there are two parts. There is the gematik part, which mainly certifies the communication with the different technical systems like the Fachdienst and the identity provider. And there is the domain perspective, which is given by the KBV. This is mainly checking that the fire bundles that you're creating, that they are in line with the specification. And in the end, you have to validate your fire bundles against the KBV. And what they do, they provide this document. And this document, I think it has 13 test cases. And I will explain some of the test cases and how you provide the data. So in the end, what you have to do is you have to create a zip and you have to upload this zip to the Prüfportal. I will show you this later. Then there are multiple kinds of test data. So there are these are some patients and here are also some doctors. And in our case, we are reading this data from XML. So actually I can show you in the ERPS application where we have this data. So here are the resources. And then there is the KBV certification examples. And in this folders, we have the doctors. So this is the machine readable version of the doctors. Basically, these are bundles that have the practitioners, the doctors in it. And then also we have a folder with the patients. And here we have the different XML examples. This is normally also what you read from an EGK, from an elektronische Gesundheitskarte. And there's some general data and this is the personal data. And this is provided by KBV. And then also currently they still require some outdated fire profiles. So they say they need fire profile 1.0.1. But this is already outdated. So there's already a new version 1.0.2 and this has to be used at the latest on the 1st January 2022. So now let's have a small walkthrough through the PF01. This is a normal PZN prescription. In the end, what you have to hand in is you have to hand in the XML file of the e-prescription. You have to hand in the signed ERP file. You have to hand in a screenshot which shows the visualization of the signing. And you have to hand in a screenshot of the display where you apply the style sheet. So the style sheet should give the doctor the possibility to validate what he's seeing. And I will just show you the different things that you have to hand in. So the most important thing is the printout. So that's the printout that you have to hand in. And I will just tell you a little bit what's important. So it's very important that this data matrix code is of 5 cm × 5 cm. Then here for the first name, you're only allowed to use 2 lines. And what you have to do is if it's too long, you have to scale it down. So by default, you have to use a font which is 12 pixel or 12 points. And if the space is not enough, you have to scale down to 10 points. Here you have to put in the doctor and this part here, at the moment it still shows the qualification of the doctor, but it will change to I think the Betriebsstätte. So there's currently a change in the documentation that this has to change. And then here you have to put in the medication and the medication string, there's a very strict rule how it has to be. So it has to be the amount, the name, then the strength, I think so, and then the amount, how much is in one package. And then in the end, the size of the package. This is the dosage instruction and this is the PZN. And for example, it's very important that you don't put a space here. So it's just the colon and then directly the PZN without a space. And this is how this has to look like. Then you have the two screenshots. So the first screenshot just shows in general how the software should look like. The important thing is that you show that there is a batch signing process. So in our case, it's this button. So this is still an old screenshot. On the new version, it shows for us now sign all prescription in batch. And the second important thing is that you show a screenshot of your software where you show the visualized version of the XSLT prescription sheet. And the important thing is there are two important things if you do that. One thing is that in the XML, the prescription ID has to be the same on the screenshot like in the XML. So here you can see that this prescription ID, it ends with 49, and it has to be the same like here in this document. So this is important. And the other important thing is that the Prüfnummer, which is your certification number, is the same. So also if we say search here for Prüfnummer here. So this Prüfnummer, it has to be this Prüfnummer here. This is what the KBV wants to see. And if you do this correctly, it will work. And then there is the last document. It's the signed ERP file. And I will just show you the I can show you it in the Explorer. So this is the signed ERP file. And this is PKCS7 file, which is ASN1 encoded. And it uses, it's called CMS. CMS stands for, let me just search for it. So RFC cryptography CMS. Yeah, so it stands for cryptographic message signature, cryptographic message syntax. And I can just show you how you can debug this. So there is an OpenSSL, there are basically two commands. So OpenSSL, and then there is the CMS command. And let's just check if I have something here. No, then there's one ASN1 parse, and then we can hand this in, and then PVC01.p, and I think in form dare. Yeah, so this was correct. This is the dare encoded. And now you can see here that I decoded this whole PKC as 7 signed data. And this is the original prescription. So this is the XML. And then the other parts are the certifications and the name of the certificate itself. So this is how this looks like. And also you can also use the OpenSSL CMS command. So there's this one here. And if you, let's try help. Yeah, so here's the help. And this will work as well. So this will also give you a little bit more information compared to the ASN1 parse syntax. And this should help you to dig into these details. So then this was the first test case. There are also other ones. They are all similar. So they first say, okay, you have some preconditions, what you have to do in your systems. Then then you do certain steps, and you save certain things. And in the end, these things are sent to the KBV. And you will find all these files that you have to hand in, as an example, in the KBV/zip folder. So here we provide examples how this results have to look like. Okay, so that's it, and thanks a lot.